Honda has recently created a lot of hype with the launch of its CB350, also dubbed as the Honda Highness. This motorcycle has been launched exclusively for the Indian market to challenge the paradigm set by Royal Enfield in the modern classics segment. There are numerous videos on the internet that will give you the features of the new motorcycle and also give you a spec-by-spec comparison with the various Royal Enfield models. This is not the intention of this video. This video will focus on the four things that I dislike about the new Honda Highness and the reasons for it. You are watching SOFE2. At the beginning of this video, let me make it clear that I am not a Royal Enfield fanboy. I do not reject any product offering in this segment simply because it has been offered by another company. In fact, I believe that the modern classics motorcycle segment has just started to get a lot more interesting. The winner is always the customer whenever there is competition. I am also very sure that there are a lot of people out there who are interested in this bike and for a good reason. The front look of the motorcycle is quite stunning. The all-LED headlamp and also the LED indicators offer a good touch to the motorcycle. The MRF tires used on the motorcycle are not only functional but also good looking. The tires are broader than the ones offered on the Royal Enfield Classic 350. The engine, though similar in size, has a slightly better performance. The weight of the bike is lesser and also the seat height is 80 mm. This would definitely improve the overall control and handling of the bike. Modern features such as Bluetooth connectivity and the console of the bike surely improve the overall riding experience of the motorcycle. Royal Enfield in general and Classic 350 in particular is the highest selling motorcycle in the mid-size neo-retro space. This is the space with a huge growth potential and Honda definitely wants a piece of this cake. To break the monopoly in any market, you need to be different from the existing market leader. This can be done by either being technologically superior or by offering incredibly good looks or by creating a brand identity that fulfills a previously unfulfilled aspiration of the consumer. Honda unfortunately fails on all three counts. What really disappointed me, and I'm not alone in feeling this way, is the motorcycle itself. Honda has been teasing about the launch of this new motorcycle for over a month. Everyone was expecting the Honda Rebel. What we got instead was the CB350. This was quite an anticlimax. The Honda Rebel 300 is an incredible looking motorcycle. It would have been a new gold standard for the new retro cruiser space in India. It could have been a perfect foil to the soon to be launched Meteor 350 of Royal Enfield. Honda instead decided to play safe and delivered a tepid CB350. Honda has disappointingly opted for the Me Too route. The product offered is very much similar to the Classic 350 for its own good. Though Honda has put in a lot of effort to make a good motorcycle, it at some point seems to have lost the plot. Honda does not have the same legacy or history as Royal Enfield or even Jawa. It does not share the same mind space, nor does it generate the same emotions in the mind of the consumer as a Royal Enfield, Jawa, or YezD. The on-paper specs of the motorcycle show it to be marginally better than the market leader. Would the marginally better specs be enough to overcome the huge emotional and psychological disadvantage the bike has over its rivals? The branding itself is a huge disappointment. Honda could not register the word Highness and therefore has gone ahead and registered the word Hness, pronounced as Highness. As is apparent, the motorcycle manufacturer wanted a word associated with royalty, and the reason is more than apparent to everyone. It wants to leave no one in doubt who it is competing against. This makes the bike look like a wannabe. Furthermore, the name Highness sounds like a compromise on the part of the company and feels rushed. It seems like they could not think of an appropriate name before the launch of the vehicle and just selected a name for the sake of it. The name Highness simply does not ring a bell and does not suit the personality of the bike. They would have been much better off by just calling it CB350. To make matters worse, the 3D badges on the motorcycle are red in color and stick out like a sore thumb. The marketing team in this case seems to have delivered a dud. Such lackadaisical attitude towards branding is surprising from a company like Honda. To design the new bike, Honda has taken inspiration from its own CB350 motorcycles of the past. The CB350 of the 60s and the 70s was a beautiful machine and was ahead of its times. The latest rendition of this motorcycle, to put it politely, is uninspiring. The red maroon version of the new Honda Highness looks like a modern take on the Hero Honda CB100 of the 80s. Remember the 80 km per liter ad? Honda has an excellent designing and engineering team. If they really wanted inspiration, they could have simply borrowed the looks from its own CB1100 RS or the CB1000 R. Both of them are enormously gorgeous motorcycles, though the CB1100 RS would have been the right source of inspiration in this case. Honda has the capability of being the market leader but has instead chosen to be an also-ran. Do you agree with my opinion? If you think I have been overtly harsh or unfair, do let me know. I would like to hear your take on this motorcycle. I will meet you again shortly with a new video on the world of motorcycles. Until then, peace out.